أعوذ بالله السميع العليم من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أعظم الله أجورنا وأجوركم بمصابنا بالحسين، وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وآله الطاهرين. الله صل على محمد. لا سيما بقية الله في الأراضين، روحي وأرواح العالمين لتراب مقدمه الفداء. Tonight is a very hard night for the Ahlul Bayt, especially for our Imam, Salatullah Wasalamu Alayhi. This dua that we recite is a dua for the well-being and the health of our Imam. So let's recite it all together. اللهم كن وليك الحجة ابن الحسن، صلواتك علي وعلى آبائه في هذه الساعة وفي كل ساعة، وليا وحافظا وقائدا وناصرا ودليلا وعينا حتى تسكنه أرضك طوعا وتمتعه فيها طويلا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم عجل وليك الفرج والعافية والنصر، ومد في عمره الشريف، وزين الأرض بطول بقائه، واجعلنا من خير أعوانه وأنصاره والمستشهدين بين يدي. For the hastening of the reappearance, the return of our Master, the Savior, the Avenger, Al-Hujjat ibn al-Hasan al-Askari, please recite aloud salawat ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. As-salamu ala al-murammal bid-dima. Salutations be upon those individuals that were covered in their bloods. As-salamu ala al-mahtuk al-khiba. Salutations be upon those who their tents were violated. As-salamu ala qatil al-ad'iya. Salutations be upon those that were slaughtered and killed by bastards. As-salamu ala man bakathu malaikatu as-sama. Salutations be upon those that the angels of the heavens cried for them. Tonight is a night that we must cry. Try to cry as much as you can. Ahlul Bayt, إِنَّ يَوْمَ الْحُسَيْنِ أَقْرَحَ جُفُونَنَا. The day of Hussein injured our eyes, meaning we cried so much on this day, and Ahlul Bayt cried so much on that day that their eyes were injured. وَأَسْبَلَ دُمُوعَنَا, and our tears were rolling on these days. السلام على الجيوب المضرجات. Salutations be upon those individuals that their garments were covered in blood. السلام على الأجساد العاريات. Salutations be upon those bodies that were left without clothes. السلام على الجسوم الشاحبات. Salutations be upon those bodies that were left and their bloods were drained to an amount that their bodies had become pale. السلام على الدماء السائلات. Salutation be upon those bloods that were flowing. Karbala had become a sea of blood on the day of Ashura. السلام على الأعضاء المقطعات. Salutations be upon those dismembered bodies. السلام على الرؤوس المشالات. Salutations be upon those heads that were put on display on spikes. السلام على النسوة البارزات. Salutations be upon those ladies that had to run out of their tents. Tonight is not a night to preach. Tonight is a night of grief. Tonight is a night to weep and cry. And I don't intend to preach and give a speech. Sallallahu alayki ya Abu Abdullah. The name of Hussein breaks the heart of a mu'min. Inna lil Hussein ma'rifatan maknunatan fi qulubil mu'minin. For Hussein salamullah alayhi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has put a concealed conviction, a concealed knowing in the heart of the mu'mineen. From the day, from the 6th of Muharram, Ubaydullah ibn Ziyad la'natullahi alayhima, he insisted and continuously sent letters to Umar ibn Sa'd la'natullahi alayhima to kill Sayyid al-Shuhada. He really urged Umar ibn Sa'd to kill Sayyid al-Shuhada to an extent that until the 9th day he sent Shimr ibn al-Jawshan with an army to make sure that Umar ibn Sa'd is going to get the job done. La'natullah alayhim ajma'een. He sent several letters until the 9th of Muharram. One day before Ashura, Umar ibn Sa'd decided to kill Sayyid al-Shuhada. He told the army to set a military formation. He ordered the army of Yazid to attack the camp of Sayyid al-Shuhada one day before Ashura on the 9th of Muharram. So they started the attack. Abul Fadl al-Abbas salamullah alayhi came to Sayyid al-Shuhada and told Sayyid al-Shuhada, "The army of Yazid are attacking." Sayyid al-Shuhada told Abul Fadl al-Abbas, "Go and ask them, why are they attacking today? What's going on? What's the news?" So Abul Fadl al-Abbas salamullahi alayhi went to the army with Habib ibn Madahir and Zuhair ibn Qayn and asked them, "Why are you guys attacking today? What's going on? Why did you attempt to attack today?" They said, "The command has come from Ibn Ziyad. Either you accept the oath of allegiance, either it's war. No third option." So Abul Fadl al-Abbas told them, "Don't rush. Why are you guys rushing? Wait, have patience. Let me go speak to my master, Sayyid al-Shuhada, salamullah alayh, and ask what to do. So Abul Fadl Abbas came to Sayyid al-Shuhada and told them that the command has come and they want to wage war. They want to start the battle. Sayyid al-Shuhada asked them, he told Abul Fadl Abbas, ask them to delay the war for one day. Negotiate with them so they would give us one more day. So Abul Fadl Abbas went to the army of Yazid and negotiated with them and spoke to them and asked them if they could delay the war, give them an extension. Because Sayyid al-Shuhada had told Abul Fadl Abbas, tonight I want to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I want to pray, I want to recite the Quran. So they accepted, la'natullahi alayhim. They said, okay, we'll wait another day. Tomorrow, we'll start the battle. Abul Fadl Abbas came back to Sayyid al-Shuhada. Sayyid al-Shuhada gathered all the companions, his brothers, his cousins, his nephews. He gave a sermon on the night of Ashura, such a night, the likes of tonight. Then in that sermon, Abi Abdullah salawatullah salamu alayhi said, "Inni la a'lamu ashaban awfa wa la khayran min ashabi." Meaning, I don't know any companion more loyal than my companions. When the Imam, when the divine knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I don't know, that means it doesn't exist, so he would know. It's like Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, I don't know. If the Imam says, I don't know any companions more loyal than my companions, that means there are no companions more loyal than the companions of Sayyid al-Shuhada, salawatullah alayhim ajma'een. وَلَا خَيْرًا مِنْ أَصْحَابِي. And I don't know any companions better than my companions. وَلَا أَهْلَ بَيْتٍ أَبَرَّ وَلَا أَوْصَلَ مِنْ أَهْلَ بَيْتِي. And I don't know any family that are more kind and are more supportive than my family. فَجَزَاكُمُ اللَّهُ عَنِّي خَيْرًا. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reward you on my behalf, the best of rewards. Then he told them, today is the last day. Tomorrow everyone's going to die. Know this, I have given you permission to leave. Use the darkness of the night, you can go. If you think there's an oath of allegiance, there's an oath upon you to stay, I take that oath off you. You can leave. Use the darkness of the night and escape. Save yourself. Abul Fadl al-Abbas stood up and he said, we will never let go of you, Ya Aba Abdullah, Sayyidi wa Mawlai. We will never stop supporting you. Then every single member of the family of Sayyid al-Shuhada stood up and declared and announced their support to Sayyid al-Shuhada, and every single companion followed and they stood up and they said they will not stop supporting Sayyid al-Shuhada salamullah alayhi. The night of Ashura, Abul Fadl al-Abbas and Zuhayr ibn Qayn were in charge of protecting and guarding the tents of Abi Abdullah salamullah alayhi. That night, Nafi' ibn Hilal narrates that I saw Sayyid al-Shuhada walking around the hills of Karbala, looking at the hills up and down. The Imam saw Nafi' and told him, Ya Nafi', why have you come out of your tent? He said, Ya Sayyidi wa Mawlai, I'm scared for your life from this nation of tyrants. They might do something to you. I'm scared for you. Imam told him, Nafi', I've come to examine the hills. I've come to see the up and downs of this battlefield, to see how this field is. Tomorrow they're going to be slayed on this field. Tomorrow they are going to spill the blood of the family of the Prophet on these fields. So the Imam is examining, is looking at the places that his Aliyun al-Akbar might be killed, the spots that his brother's going to fall down, the spot where Qasim is going to be trampled. And then the Imam told Nafi', don't you want to escape? Don't you want to use the darkness of the night and save yourself? These guys want me. Go and save yourself. Nafi' threw himself on the foot of Sayyid al-Shuhada. And he told, as long as I have a sword and the ride, I will never stop supporting you, Ya Sayyidi wa Mawlai. Then after this, Sayyid al-Shuhada salamullah alayhi went to the tent of Lady Zainab salamullah alayhi. Nafi' narrates, I was waiting outside the tent, waiting for Sayyid al-Shuhada salamullah alayhi. I heard Zainab al-Kubra speaking to Sayyid al-Shuhada. What was Lady Zainab saying on the last night that Sayyid al-Shuhada is alive? Zainab al-Kubra, Nafi' says, I heard Zainab al-Kubra saying, Ya Akhi, Ya Sayyidi, Ya Mawla, Ya Aba Abdullah, have you trialed and tested these companions? I'm worried they might surrender you in the last moment. Have you tested them? Are they loyal? Then the Imam told Lady Zainab, yes, I have tested them. They are more keen towards death than a baby towards its mother. Then Nafi', when he heard and found out that Lady Zainab is worried about the loyalty of the companions of Sayyid al-Shuhada, he went and spoke to Habib ibn Madahir al-Asadi. This happened on the night of Ashura. Lady Zainab is worried. Nothing has happened yet. There's no danger yet. Only Lady Zainab is worried. Maybe the companions are not loyal. So Nafi' went and spoke to Habib ibn Madahir and told Habib, the daughter of Amir al-Mu'mineen is worried. We might not be loyal. Habib went and spoke to Banu Hashim. He told Bani Hashim, the tribe of Hashim, which were the family of Imam Hussein salamullah alayhi, he told them to all go inside their tents. So Banu Hashim, they all went inside their tents, and Habib gathered all the companions and told them, Lady Zainab salamullahi alayhi is worried that we might not be loyal. We might surrender Sayyid al-Shuhada. Then the companions, they all said, if it wasn't for the command of Sayyid al-Shuhada, if we weren't waiting for Sayyid al-Shuhada to command us, we would have attacked the enemy tonight. The Habib ibn Madahir gathered the companions and told them to go around the tents of Banu Hashim, go around the tents of the family of Sayyid al-Shuhada. They all with one sound, they started chanting in support of the family of the Prophet. They were saying, these swords of us will not go inside their cases until it would slay the neck of your enemies, O family of the Prophet. These spears that we have will only strike the chest of your enemies, O family of the Prophet. So they announced their support by chanting these words. Sayyid al-Shuhada spent that night praying and reciting Quran. Where were these companions of Sayyid al-Shuhada? Where were those swords? Where were those spears? Where was Habib when Sayyid al-Shuhada, the likes of tomorrow afternoon, where was Zuhair? Where was Burair? The likes of the afternoon of Ashura, that Sayyid al-Shuhada had no companions left. Abbas was a slave next to the river of Furat into pieces. Qasim, Ali al-Akbar, the sons of Aqil, Habib, Burayl, Zuhayl, all the companions were slain. And Sayyid al-Shuhada all of a sudden found himself all alone. Hisham ibn Muhammad narrates, when Sayyid al-Shuhada realized the army of Yazid really insists on killing Sayyid al-Shuhada salamullahi alayhi, Imam Hussein picked up the Quran. Sayyid al-Shuhada picked up the Quran and opened the Quran and placed the Quran above his head. And he called the army of Yazid and told them, بيني وبينكم كتاب الله وجدي محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله. Let the book of God be the judge between me and you. Let my grandfather Muhammad صلى الله عليه وآله be the judge between me and you. Let's be fair. يا قوم لما تستحلون دمي. Oh group of people, oh people, what's the reason that you permit killing me? Why am I not the son of the daughter of your prophet? أما أنا ابنة نبيكم. أما وصل إليكم قول رسول الله. هذان سيدا شباب أهل الجنة. Many of the people that stood in the face of Sayyid al-Shuhada, they had seen the Prophet. If not, they had seen the companions of the Prophet. So Sayyid al-Shuhada is telling them, have you not heard the Prophet say, me and my brother are the masters of the youth of paradise. Why do you permit slaughtering me? Why do you want to kill me? لا إله إلا الله. They didn't pay any attention. And then Sayyid al-Shuhada called, هل من ناصر ينصرني? Is there anyone to help me? Sayyid al-Shuhada is begging them. رحم الله من نادى وغربتا. هل من ناصر ينصرني? Is there anyone to help me? هل من موحد يرعى حقنا? Is there any God believer? Are there any believers amongst you that would respect the sanctity of the family of the Prophet? At this point, the ladies of Banu Hashim started crying out loud. وغربته وحسينا. They say Zainab al-Kubra came to Sayyid al-Shuhada. She had a baby in her hand. وويلاه ورضيعاه. She gave that baby to Sayyid al-Shuhada. يا أخي, this baby, oh brother, this baby is dying from thirst. Sayyid al-Shuhada held the baby on his hands and faced the army of Yazid. يا قام قد قتلتم شيعتي. Oh people, you have killed my followers, you have killed my companions. قد قتلتم شيعتي وأهل بيتي. You have killed my family members. وقد بقي هذا الطيف يتلظى عطشا. Only this baby is left for me. Look at him, how is he shaking from thirst. فسقوه شربة من الماء. I ask you to give him a small drip of water. يا قام إن لم ترحموني فارحموا هذا الطيف. If you don't have mercy on me, have mercy on this baby. واختلف القوم فيما بينهم فمنهم من قال لا تسقوه. And then a disagreement, a fight erupted in the army of Yazid. A group said, don't give him water. ومنهم من قال وسقوه. A group said, give him water, he's just an innocent baby. ومنهم من قال لا تبقوا لأهل هذا البيت باقيا. A group said, don't leave even a single member of them alive, meaning kill all of them. عندها التفت عمر بن سعد إلى حرملة بن كاهل الأسدي لعنة الله عليهما. عمر بن سعد faced حرملة. What did he tell حرملة? He said, يا حرملة اقطع نزاع القوم. Oh حرملة, stop this disagreement inside the army of Yazid. حرملة says, فهمت كلام الأمير فسددت السهم في كبد القوس. I understood what Umar ibn Sa'd said. فسددت السهم في كبد القوس. I placed my arrow inside my bow. وصرت أنتظر أين أرمي. I was looking where to shoot the arrow. فبينما أنا كذلك, when I was looking around to find my target, إذ لاحت مني التفاتة إلى رقبة الطفل. The neck of the baby on the hand of سيد الشهداء grabbed my attention. وكان الرضيع مغمى علي من شدة الظما. The baby had fainted on the hand of Sayyid al-Shuhada from thirst. Imagine a baby on the hand of Sayyid al-Shuhada and his neck is falling down. His head is facing the ground. وكان الرضيع مغمى علي من شدة الظما وهي تلمع على عضد أبيها الحسين كأنها إبريق فضة. The neck of that baby was shining like a silver dish. عندها رميته بالساه. I shot my arrow towards the neck of the baby. رحم الله من نادى وعليا. فلما وصل إليه الساه ذبحه من الوريد إلى الوريد. وحسينا رحم الله من نادى وعليا. When the arrow
the neck of the baby. It cut the neck of the baby from his ears to his other ears. Harmala is saying what he was citing on the day of Ashura. فَلَمَّا أَحَسَّ بِحَرَارَةِ السَّاهِ. When the baby felt the heat of the arrow, رَفَعَ يَدَيْهِ مِنْ تَحْتِ قِمَاطِهِ وَاَعْتَنَقَ أَبَاهُ الْحُسَيْنِ. The baby started flipping and the baby pulled out his hand and he reached towards the neck of سيد الشهداء وصار يرفرف بين يداي كالطير المذبوح. The baby was shaking like a bird that has been beheaded. رحم الله من نادى وحسينا. رحم الله من نادى ورضيعاه. عندئذ وضع الحسين يده تحت نحر الرضيع حتى امتلأت دماء. سيد الشهداء placed his hands under the neck of علي الأصغر until it was filled with the blood of علي الأصغر ورمى بها نحو السماء. He threw the blood towards the skies. ثم قال هون علي ما نزل بي أنه بعين الله. يا الله, the fact that you see it makes this tragedy easy on me. روي عن الباقر, it is narrated from Imam الباقر, لم يسقط من ذلك الدم قطرة إلى الأرض. Not a single drop of this blood returned to the ground. وسمع مناديا يقول. Then a munadi came from the skies. دعه يا حسين فإن له مرضعا في الجنة. Let go of your baby, oh Hussein. We have appointed a wet nurse to feed your baby. رحم الله من نادى وعليا. رحم الله من نادى وحسينا. And then سيد الشهداء, his baby is beheaded. The mother is waiting within the tent. Lady Zainab is waiting inside. What did سيد الشهداء do? It is narrated, he returned towards the tent. But in what state? In a state of confusion. What am I going to do? What am I going to say to the mother? I went and asked for water, but they beheaded my child. What did Sayyid al-Shuhada do? One of the cursed men from the army of Yazid narrates, I saw Hussein ibn Ali go behind the tent and he opened the grave with his sword and he buried his baby behind the tent. رحم الله من نادى وحسينا.